Hey Star Wars fans, another FlyGuy.net figure review. This is part two of two. We reviewed a comic pack with Justin Mareel and Montrose, and we showed you this guy in part one, and that is Montrose. And if you want to watch that, head on to the channel and you can get a review of this guy, this very cool Boba Fett, Jango Fett, I should say, kind of part of his history, and he's a really cool figure. So check that one out if you want to have a look at that. This one we're going to review is his counterpart, Jaster Mareel. And let me do our usual zoom in on this guy. Where are we going? There we go. So a completely new sculpt in most parts, certainly on the chest element for these kind of Mandalorian figures that we've seen before. Pretty much a reused Jango Fett helmet, as you'll see. Some nice accoutrements and attachments as well. A new set of holsters there for his custom pistols, which we've never seen before. And this rather cool looking gun with a knife on the end there as well. But let me take a look at all the other attachments separately, bit by bit. Let's take a look at the backpack first of all. Let me just zoom in on that, give you a look. Slightly different than we've seen before. It's kind of like the Jango Fett second version that he had at the Geonosis Arena. So it's not the rocket launching one, but the kind of, I don't know the exact term or name for it, but certainly the one that appeared in Attack of the Clones later on in the film. And of course, that's fully detachable. Whoops. Comes off and you get to see behind it. Quite a different looking piece. I've certainly never seen it before. It may well be the exact one. I should have dug out a Jango to have a look there, but that's the backpack for all you people that want to know. None of those rocket firing rocket pieces we talked about in the previous review, which I would have loved to have seen, and even in the Jango Fett vintage review we did, I'd love to see a Hasbro figure that gives us this flame effect that they've done before. Well, it certainly appeared on an old Boba Fett figure, which was the Pit of Carkoon. Really rather cool, but there we go, that's the backpack. Cape is not removable unless you take the head off. We'll have a look at the standard helmet first of all. So the viewfinder is fixed, and it's just a piece of plastic. Mine's been a little bit bent in the package, but a nice red paint all the way through. I love red on clones, it always looks very smart, and I think you'll probably like that as well. Cool little helmet. Nothing as usual in between. And there we go. You can take the cape off Jaster Mareel just by, well, I'll take his head off first of all. There we go. And put it back on. Jaster Mareel. That's what it looks like. And pretty much from the comic that comes with it, which I should actually briefly show you because I talked about it in the last one, there is the likeness of Jaster Mareel. Let me try and get that in together. Cartooning a very good job here, Steven. Come on. There you go. So close-ish, certainly a little bit different from the comic book, but not too bad. Still a cool figure. The comic that comes with it, as I mentioned before, is Jango Fett Open Seasons. Let me just zoom a little better on that. Beautiful artwork on the cover. If you've never seen this in the old print or the old version, it's a very cool story, one that talks about Jango Fett's evolutions in his story, and obviously ties in Justin and Leland Montrose from the pretty awesome cutscenes in the video game Jango Fett Bounty Hunter. So a really cool piece of story in there. As all the comics, full colour, some gorgeous looking artwork, particularly if you love Mandalorians. You're going to love this if you've never seen it before. Really, really cool pieces of art within it. And definitely one I'd recommend. Even just picking up for the reprint of the comic, it's a beautiful piece. But there you go. I love Mandalorians and clones. Enough of that. On with the figure. So attachments and other things that come with a figure. Let me just take the rifle off and show you that. I'll zoom in and give you a better effect of it. Let me just, there we go. So again, some nice detail from Hasbro. You can just see if you make out on the, let me see if I get a better shot of it. On the end of the gun there is actually a tiny Bantha skull symbol of the Mandalorian. So a really nice touch that Hasbro have added in. There you go. Let's see if it's tight as I can get it. but a nice piece added on to the figure then again just adds a nice piece of authenticity to the story and adds in all the characters. So let me just flip the other side, and it's on the other side too. It's a really cool weapon, one I've never seen before with a Star Wars figure. Someone please tell me if we have, but I don't think so. So again, heads up to Hasbro for giving us something new and different with a viewfinder. It fits the figure really well. Both of these figures really are pretty well made in terms of articulation and whatnot, but some other features we should talk about first, as I mentioned, was the blasters. Again, there's a different, this one's a bit squashed in the holster, but two of these in the pack. No symbol sadly on the handle, but another cool set of blasters. And the pouches again are completely different. All these utility belts I've never seen before. There's a fair bit of difference on each of this huge one at the back. Let me go around and just show you again the back of it. Now let me just properly give you a quick look at the figure and just as much as I can in focus. Let me just go back. There we go. So again, a pretty cool figure overall. It seems to reuse Jango Fett legs that we've seen before. I think it's the same legs that are actually in the Jango Fett vintage collection that we've reviewed and has just hit the street in the last couple of weeks. And also Jango Fett gauntlets on his arms, same as before. But that utility belt is all completely new. And some nice patches now, and it's on the shoulder. Again, comic accurate. Nice touches by Hasbro. Pretty cool figure all in. So articulation-wise, what have we got on the head? Well, he's mounted on a ball, so you can move that around and get pretty decent movement. On the shoulders, even though you can see that they are ball jointed, so you can move them up to a certain degree, to a certain point, they'll move. Again, just like a normal Jango figure that we've seen in recent years, there's articulation at the elbow, and there's also the second piece which moves because of the cables that go into the gauntlet on his arm. It's all one molded piece on that gauntlet, so you don't get any wrist articulation. And the same is on the other arm. Let me just move that up. You get that at the elbow, and this other plastic piece which moves around with the figure just for those cables that go into the gauntlet again. None of the blades that we've seen on the vintage collection Jango Fett appear there, but again, pretty good on the arms. Waist articulation, full on rounds. Not ball jointed, but certainly swivel hips. So again, plenty of movement on there. Ball jointed knees, same as any Jango figure that's been out recently. And good old ankle articulation as well. So pretty good figure all in for the articulation front. This will really let you pose this guy pretty well. He is quite heavy by the time you put the cloak and the jetpack on and the helmet and the gun and all the rest of it. So if you've got him in a very kind of dramatic pose, he probably can fall over a little bit like the Montrose that I've got him in. He's a little bit heavy, so you might need to have a glue or blue tack or something to hold him up. But there you go. This is Jester Mareel. He's an Entertainment Earth exclusive comic pack. We'll put a link under the video. You can pick that up if you want to. Bit of a bargain, I have to say. $17.99 US dollars plus shipping. Certainly allows you to get these two figures and the comic pack. This is a bit of a bargain for overseas people, I think, considering that the average price of a figure for us alone is $18. So, yeah, pretty good. And one I really like. That's the two of them in the pack. And again, check out the review in the channel for the Montrose figure, which we've already covered. There you go. Hope you like them. Hope that maybe helps you decide whether you want to buy them or not. I certainly recommend you do. They're really cool figures. And click on the link below the video and that'll take you there. Drop a comment. Let us know what you think. If you're buying them, if you're not, how much they cost in your country. I'd love to know. And we'll see you for another video real soon. Cheers.